Hey guys, I hope you're having a good week so far. Sorry I'm a little late this week. I have been a bit under the weather, but anyways, this week is going to be about Nikola Tesla. Nikola Tesla was born on the 10th of July, 1856 in Smiljan, Croatia. Sorry, I hope I'm pronouncing that right. He was the fourth child of an Orthodox priest, Milutin, and his wife, Georgina. Tesla had four siblings, Milka, Angelina, Danilo, or Dane, and Marija Marisa. Until the age of six, Tesla lived in Smiljan, Croatia. His mother was talented in making homemade crafts and appliances and was very good at the memorization of Serbian poems. She never had a formal education, and Tesla credited his abilities to his mother's influence and genetics. In 1862, his family moved to Gospic, Lika, where Tesla's father worked as a parish priest. In 1870, Tesla moved to Karlovac, where he would attend a high school at Higher Real Gymnasium. He would become interested in demonstrations of the electricity by his physics professor. Tesla wrote, "The mysterious phenomena made him want to know more of this wonderful force." Many of Tesla's teachers believed him to be cheating because he could perform integral calculus in his head. He finished out a four-year term in 3 years and graduated in 1873. In 1875, Tesla enrolled at Austrian Polytechnic in Graz, Austria, on a military frontier scholarship. During his first year, Tesla never missed a lecture, earned the highest grades possible, was said to work from 3 a.m. to 11 p.m., not working any days off, not even holidays. But as anyone would have guessed, even Tesla couldn't keep up with that kind of schedule. After the death of his father in 1879, Tesla found letters from his professor to his father warning that unless he were to be removed from the school, Tesla would die through overwork. At the end of his second year, Tesla lost his scholarship and became addicted to gambling. Tesla gambled all of his tuition money and later gambled back all of the money, returning it to his family. Tesla had cut off all of his friends and family relationships in order to hide that he had dropped out of school, and many of his friends had thought that he had drowned in the nearby river. In January 1880, two of Tesla's uncles arranged for him to leave Gospic for Prague, where he was to study, but he did not end up studying there due to him being late and not knowing two of the required languages, Czech and Greek. In 1881, Tesla moved to Budapest, Hungary, and worked as a draftsman in the Central Telegraph Office. He had originally planned to work at the telegraph company, the Budapest Telephone Exchange, but it was under construction and not functionable. In June 1884, Tesla began his journey to the United States, where Tesla arrived in the States. He had very little, he had some clothes, and very few cents. Right away, Tesla began working at the machine works on Manhattan's Lower East Side in a small crowded shop with several hundred other people. One of the projects given to Tesla was to develop an arc lamp-based street lighting system. Tesla's design were never put into production. Edison had just invented the electric light bulb, and with there not being a system to get the electricity to the people, his solution was DC power, direct current. But DC current proved to be unstable and proved to break down. Edison went to Nikola Tesla with an offer of $50,000 as a bonus to fix his failing generators. Tesla worked on the generators for months, but when he had them fixed and came back and asked for $50,000, Edison says that he was only joking and that Tesla didn't understand his American humor. Tesla had been working on the machine works for a total of 6 months when he quit. Soon after leaving the Edison company, Tesla started working and patenting an arc lighting system, possibly the same one that he had developed at Edison. Tesla went on to create AC, or alternating current, which is much better than Edison's direct current, which would only go about a quarter of a mile to a mile before it faded out, whereas AC could run at much higher voltage and transmit for hundreds of miles. Tesla's AC current caught the attention of George Westinghouse, who had invented air brakes on trains. He wanted to make an alliance with Tesla and thus began the well-known
War of the Currents. Ultimately, Edison failed in his efforts to discredit AC when in 1983 Westinghouse won the contract to supply electricity to the World's Fair in Chicago. Throughout Tesla's life, he patented around 300 of his inventions. There were a minimum of 278 patents issued to Tesla in 26 countries that have been accounted for. 10 of his most famous inventions were the Tesla coil, the magnifying transmitter, the Tesla turbine, the shadow graph, the neon lamp or neon lighted sign at the 1893 World's Fair in Chicago. He demonstrated neon light signs and how they can make unique designs and even form words. Teleforce, the violet ray, which was a medical appliance using high frequency and low current to the human body for therapeutical purposes. However, this wasn't a very great invention because it was causing seizures and ended up being the cause of many lawsuits, actually. And of course, we can't leave out good old death ray. Yeah, Tesla's death ray. The death ray, or the beam, was a theoretical particle beam or electromagnetic weapon. And whilst this death ray sounds quite sinister, Tesla built it meaning well, surprisingly. So according to Tesla, his invention would make it possible to create a national energy fence that would destroy any enemy that passed through it. However, he hoped that the applications of this invention could be peaceful by making it impossible for armies to attack another country. Tesla hoped that he could completely eliminate warfare. Getting on to a bit of his personal life, Nikola Tesla was always known to have a phobia of germs and was said to have avoided contact because of this. He remained celibate and never married, however, not because of his fear of germs this time. Tesla thought he was never worthy enough for a woman and thought that they were superior. Although later on in his life, his ideas on this matter started to change as he thought women were trying to outdo men and take their place. A quote from Tesla reads, "In place of the soft-voiced, gentle woman of my reverent worship has come the woman who thinks that her chief success in life lies in making herself as much possible like a man." And had reclusive tendencies when caught up in his work. However, when he was around people, there were very many positive things to be said about him. Quote from his secretary, Dorothy Skerritt, "His genial smile and nobility of bearing always denoted the gentlemanly characteristics that were so ingrained in his soul." Nikola had an accident in the fall of 1937. He had left his hotel room at the Hotel New Yorker. He was going across the street to the cathedral when he was struck by a taxi. He injured his back and broke three ribs. He never went to the doctor to get these looked at, as was his custom, and he never fully recovered. On the 7th of January, 1943, in Hotel New Yorker, in the room 3,327, Nikola died at age of 86. His body was later found by a maid who had ignored the do not disturb sign he had put up a couple of days prior. It was ruled that the cause of death was coronary thrombosis. On the 12th of January, 2,000 people attended a state funeral for Tesla at the Cathedral of St. John. Today there is a science museum in the capital of Serbia called the Nikola Tesla Museum. I hope you guys enjoyed this week's video. It was really fun to film. Let me know what you guys think about it. And see you all next time. Stay positive. Bye.